Lord this morning. If you'll go with me to the book of Matthew, chapter 15. The book of Matthew, chapter 15, starting at verse 21. Matthew, chapter 15, starting at verse 21. Matthew 15, starting at verse 21. Amen. I just want to talk for a little bit. Delivered on the crown. Delivered on the crown. That's all it takes, just the crown. Amen. Some of the stuff that other folks don't want, I'll take it. Amen. 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 Matthew 15, 21 reads, "Then Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and besought him, saying, Send her away, for she cries after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, Truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. Let us bow. Blessed Father, speak to us, O Lord. Speak from the heavens, O Lord, by the power of your Holy Spirit. Father, I decrease. O Father, you increase through the power of your Holy Spirit. Father, we need a word from the Lord. Father God, use me as your vessel, as your sounding board, that your voice may come forth by the power of your Spirit through your holy word. Be glorified in the name of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Draw souls unto your kingdom through him, that they may be reconciled back unto you. Father God, and even as the word comes forth, let deliverance spring forth, Lord. And Father God, we put the enemy on the run right now. And Father God, he has no place in your people. So Father God, he shall be cast out even now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. One of the most hurting things in the world is sometimes to be a parent. Amen. How many of y'all got children in here? Amen. Amen. One of the things that will drive you on your knees, if not flat on your face, is children. Amen. You love them with all your heart, but there are some things that not even you can do for them. But pray and let God touch them. But when it goes beyond what we can do, we got to take them to the Lord and put them in his hands. And trust that the same way our mothers and fathers pray for us, them same prayers can work for our children. In this particular text today, Jesus, having dealt with the Pharisees and the scribes again, he was speaking of them about traditions, about the washing of the hands and how that the Pharisees and scribes held to the traditions of the elders, and before they eat, they had to wash their hands a certain way with the fingers pointing up so the water can drip down off their wrists, and then another way so that they'd have someone pour water over their hands, and then another way. And Jesus said, now, y'all have taken the commandments of God and made them of none effect with your traditions. And men will take God's word and try to cramp it, trying to bring in their own stuff. And then they put those burdens upon us, and we never get to see Jesus from the stuff that they are presenting. And people, there are some people who don't get healed, don't get delivered, don't even get saved because the tradition of men has come forth and not the commandments of God. And Jesus, he got so tired of them, he just said, you know what, it's time to go. There's going to be some times in your life and my life then we're dealing with people who are religious but not spiritual. And we're going to have to depart from them because they're going to cramp you so much that you won't experience God in their presence. Because their traditions are so tight that you can't see God manifested because they are in the way. And Jesus said, you know what? I'm not going to spend too much time, y'all boys. There's somebody I need to go see. And you know what? What I found out? When folks don't want God and they'd rather have tradition, God would just simply walk on out the door. He'll go, okay, y'all don't want me. I'll take it to somebody else. I'll bless somebody else. I'll heal somebody else. I'll deliver somebody else. He said, you know what? And not only that, but I'll lift up somebody else. And I'll even put them right where you at. Look at here. And then the text today, as I transition on in, he told them, he said, you know what? He told his disciples, they had a question. And he said, now, are y'all also without understanding? He said, y'all been hanging around me. You should have some understanding by now. The Bible says, in all thy getting, get understanding. Now he says, now, don't y'all realize that even if your hand's dirty and you eat something, by the time it hits your stomach, all that acid in your stomach going to burn everything up. And it's going to get purified and it's going to come out the drop. Meaning that when you go to the bathroom, you ain't going to have to worry about nothing. All that stuff going to be purged. Y'all ain't with me, okay. Evidently, y'all ain't been to the restroom in a while then. Grandma need to give you a working off. Y'all know anything about a working off? Mama Eva know about that. She started laughing. Amen. Grandma used to give me that stuff to you. She said, baby, this is a little chocolate for you. Y'all know anything about that? And I would just eat. Ooh, that good. And then a little bit later. Oh, these new parents, they don't do that no more. Amen. Amen. Bless your heart. But he said, it's not what goes into a man that defiles him, but what comes out of a man. He says, for out of the heart proceedeth evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornication, thefts, false witness, blasphemy. These are the things which defile a man, but to eat with unwashed hand, that don't defile nobody. And then he left, and the Bible says, and Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And every now and then, Jesus said, I'm fed up. I'm through with you for the time being. I'm finished. And he'll take his word and take it to somebody who's hungry for it, who's been praying for it, who's been on their knees for it, who's been crying out for it, somebody who's been fasting. Y'all ain't with me. Who said, Lord, I'm withdrawing from the table because I want you. I'm thirsty for you. I'm hungry for you. Just like the heart panteth for the water brook, so panteth my heart after you. Oh, God, I want you. I got to have you. That's the kind of person God is looking for. And he will leave tradition and religion and seek after those who really are hungry and thirsting after him. And the Bible says he departed out of the coast of Israel. And guess where he went? To the coast of Tyre and Sidon. Now, y'all got to get this, y'all. Now, these were the places where some idolatry was going on. Now, ain't it sad when the Lord leaves what's supposed to be his people and take it to folks who are not quite as religious as, quote, we are. Y'all ain't with me. Y'all still got turkey in you and custard. Y'all a little slow to go. Y'all used to be hollering with me. But God will take his word and take it to people who really want it. If the people up in here don't want it, he'll take it to the corner. He'll take it to the folks who are sloppy drunk, filled with drugs, but crying out in the midst of what they're going through and say, God, I don't want to do this no more. Help me. And the Bible says that he took it to Tyre and Sidon. Now, Tyre actually means a rock, but it really breaks down to cramp something and to confine it. And Sidon actually means a fishery or where you actually hunt something. Y'all ain't with me. See, Jesus was on a mission to put something in confinement and to hunt after it. Y'all ain't with me. He is on the way to chase after the devil and to confine that joker so that he can't operate no more. The Bible says this, and it says, behold, a woman of Canaan cried out to him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. Now look at this. My first thought is, where the daddy at? Yeah. Y'all ain't with me. See, y'all just read through y'all Bible. I don't do that. When I read through my Bible, I start asking questions. I see mama, but where daddy at? Where the head of the house at? But you know what I found out? Women are faithful. When they birth something, they hold on to it. See, mama will hang with you when daddy say, I'm through with you. They will. Them mothers are faithful. See, you know what I found out? And I said, Lord, what's up there? He said, now, when they go through the pain of birthing it, they are connected to it. He said, but a real man gonna watch over his seed. He's going to water it. He's going to nourish it. He's going to pray for it. Y'all ain't with me. But the Bible says, behold, whenever you see behold in the Bible, that means take a look. It's a commandment to look. There was a woman of Canaan. Now, this sister was cursed. If you're a true biblical scholar, you'll realize in the book of Genesis chapter 9 that Noah got drunk on wine and his son Ham saw him naked. Went and told his brothers, Japheth and Shem, but when they did, they took a sheet and walked backwards and covered up their daddy. Well, Ham tried to expose his nakedness, and he cursed not Ham, he cursed Canaan. So all the descendants of Canaan became cursed. Be careful what you say out of your mouth over your generation. You know what I tell my child, girl, you blessed. You highly favored. You're favored of the Lord. His hand is upon you. You're going to do great things for the Lord. I don't care what the enemy tries to do. I'm going to bless him. See, don't let the enemy use you for his purposes by cursing your children. You need to speak over them. Bless them. Lay hands on them. Pour oil on them if you have to. In the middle of the night, pray over them. Speak over them. I don't care what they in, just say, God gonna grab you. You ain't gonna be able to stay in that mess. Y'all ain't with me. Put angels on the assignment over. Look at here, the Bible says here that this woman was cursed. But look at here, Jesus came to take the curse away. Look here, when other folks speak bad about you, I'm so glad that Jesus, good God Almighty, has came to bless us, not condemn us. The Bible says this, that when she came out of the same coast, you can't stay where you at if you want God's blessing. Good God Almighty. If you want to see Jesus, you got to do some movement. You got to come out of the boundaries and limitations that you used to. Come out of them old, dead, religious churches that just want to keep you bound, don't want you to see Jesus. Don't want to see no praise and worship. Don't want to pray for nobody, lay hands on the sick. Don't want to see nobody come to him. You got to get up out of where you've been. Come to meet Jesus. The Bible says she did this, that she cried. She cried. Good God Almighty. Ain't nothing that move my heart worse than a crying woman. You do something to me when I see some tears. Good God Almighty, I start reading and reaching in the pocket. Sister, what can I do? I be ready to lay hands and to pray. It's just something about seeing a woman cry that just mess with me. If you want to get me, start crying. I don't care if you fake an eye for a moment until the Holy Ghost show me what's really going on. I move. You about get me. And I say, you almost have me now. But if the Holy Ghost didn't give me the sermon, God, you know I would have gave you my whole checkbook. Y'all ain't with me. Any man that loves the Lord got a tender heart for all of God's creation. The Bible says that she cried. But the Bible says this, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. The Bible says this, and she said, have mercy on me. What this breaks down is, Lord, I need you to be compassionate on my situation. But all I need you to do, now you can do it with a word, or you can do it with your hands. However you want to do it is good with me, but all I want you to do is just move with compassion. The Bible says that God is so compassionate that his mercies are new every morning. Every time your eyes open up, 6 a.m., 7 a.m., 8 o'clock a.m., fresh mercies are falling upon you and me. Look at here. The Bible says this. The Bible says that she cried out, have mercy on me, Lord. Now, ain't it a shame when the folks who are heathens know who he is, when the folks who come through the church walls won't even acknowledge him, won't exalt him, won't lift him up, yet somebody drunk with wine say, ain't God good? Y'all ain't with me. I heard drunks giving more praise than some folks who come up in church. You know God good. Ain't he good? Then turn it up. And then us, who he got sober, who used to get drunk, won't give him no praise. Y'all ain't with me. Look here. Y'all know I'm telling the truth. You know what? When folk get drunk, they start telling the truth. Give them a little liquor and everything that's been hidden will come up. I know I'm on it. I know I'm on it. She said, Lord, have mercy upon me. But notice that her daughter was the one possessed and vexed. But yet she said, Lord, I need you to have mercy. This thing is affecting me. See, you know what? You cannot be the one that the devil is messing with, but because of what you connected to, you can be affected by it. Look at here. The Bible says this, thou son of David. Woo! She said, look at here. I know who you are. When them Pharisees and them scribes don't know, I know who you are. I know you the king. Y'all ain't with me. When she called him the son of David, she said, I know you the Messiah. I know you God who has come in the flesh. You the one who come to help me. Because you know what? They don't know what they don't want. They don't even know what Isaiah said. Isaiah said, even the Gentiles shall come to your light. So when they reject you, guess what? I'll take you. I want you. I want to praise you. I want to worship you. Even when they're arguing about you about washing hands. You know what? Church folk can trip over the most trivial stuff. You're arguing about what we should do, when we should do it. Well, what about God's people? What about the people who are on their way to hell? What about them? And you want to meet about some trivial stuff? What about God's people? What about his deliverance, his healing, his salvation? What about him wanting to minister to people's needs? What about folks who got no food in their refrigerator and need a little money to be given to? What about that? Look at here. The Bible says this. She said this. She said, I know you the son of David. I know that you are the son of David and you are the descendant of Abraham. And since you are Abraham's seed, the Bible says, in thy seed, all the nations gonna be blessed. See, you know what? We can think we got a monopoly on God that he can't help nobody else but us. Y'all ain't with me. Y'all ain't with me. Guess what? The Bible says this. She first told him who he is. See, when you go to God first, don't go asking for stuff. You got to go and talk to him. Y'all ain't with me. Y'all ain't with me. Any single sisters in the house, I'm going to give you a secret. Raise your hand if you're single. I'm going to tell you how to do this thing. I'm going to tell you. Look at him. Do the Holy Ghost now. Look at him and see the king in him.
and then speak to the king in it. See, don't listen to your girlfriend. Oh, good, he ain't about not. Nah, talk to the king in it. Boy, that bald head know it look good. Woo, good God Almighty. Oh, God gonna use you, brother. See, you know what he started doing? See, you start speaking to the areas in him that's like God. Y'all see that? See, y'all ain't with me. That's why some of y'all having a hard time. Y'all ain't speaking to the king in him. When you speak to the king in him, that joker will give you every dime he got. Except for the tithe money. Now, that belongs to the Lord. But girl, boy, my wife need to talk to me, girl, you need some new shoes. Y'all won't work with me. I'm trying to help you out. Look here, every brother in here, if they'll be real with you, they ain't as hard as they say they are. But guess what? They want to hear them sweet words. Woo, boy, ain't nobody like you. I just like the way you walk. You walk with strength. Y'all ain't with me. Y'all so holy. Y'all, somebody talking to somebody, all these children up in here. Good God Almighty, somebody talking to somebody. Either you lying or you telling the truth. Sherman, I don't know if you want to put this on YouTube right here, bro. Look at here. She talked to Jesus in a way that the Pharisees and the scribes did not, even though they knew the word, yet they didn't know the God who gave them the word. See, you know what? You can know the word, but not know the God who gave the word. Look at here. The Bible says she did this. Then she stated her case after she told him who he was. Look at here. She said, my daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. Look here. Jesus, she got a bad case. She got a bad case. She got a bad case. She threw. Ain't seen. Look at, some of y'all got children, y'all ain't seen them in a while. But you know what? Prayer will drag them back home. They try to smoke, can't get high no more, drink, can't get drunk. Get to the point where they just get tired of running around. They will. Prayer will change their heart. You know what prayer does? Prayer gives God permission to get involved in your case. See, you got to take it to God and say, God, get involved with him. Get involved with her. God, that gives God's license to get involved. Whatever God going to do, you got to open your mouth and say, Lord, you do it. Look at here. She's possessed with a devil. Somehow the devil got interest into her life. And when Noah spoke over his son Ham, he messed around and messed up his whole generation. Look at here. Don't tell nobody you ain't no good. Because you know what's going to happen? That's going to remain with them. And that same stuff that you spoke over them will start passing down the generation. I told my daughter already, I said, good, my whole generation blessed. What y'all looking at me like that for? Anything come up out of me, I'm anointed with the Holy Ghost. So whatever come out, bow, they holy too. Y'all ain't with me. I'm heart circumcised. You know what that means? That whatever seed come out of me is marked to be blessed. Y'all don't understand who you are. The Bible says this. Look at here. She's possessed with a devil. But the Bible says this. These signs shall follow them that believe. They shall lay hands on the sick. They shall cast out. Okay. Well, that means to tell me that if ain't nobody being healed and ain't no devils being cast out, I want to know, do you believe? Y'all ain't with me. Look at here. The Bible says in Isaiah 7:14, and behold, the Lord should give you a sign. I'm working with it here. Look here. Jesus ain't no healing, no deliverance going on. Jesus ain't in the house then. Look at here. The Bible says here, but he answered her not a word. I said, wait a minute now, Lord. This woman don't mess around and told you who you are, and you ain't moved. Something ain't wrong now. Every time I read my Bible, when folk go to worshiping and praising, you start moving. But she didn't even get a word. Look at here. Y'all ever heard read your Bible, load a bar, would mean no word? Have you ever felt that you reading your Bible, but it just ain't sinking in? You talking to God, but it seems like he ain't talking to you? Don't stop talking. Don't stop reading. Don't stop meditating. Don't stop praying. Don't stop fasting. Keep pressing in. All he want to do is see if you're going to keep doing it. See, when God goes silent and you keep talking to him, worshiping him, praising him, exalting him, guess what? Broke still say, God, you're still good. Sick, God, you a healer anyway. I know you are. Bad report, God, I know you a healer. Tell the doctor, I know he gonna touch me. He already don't touch me. I just gotta get it in my system. Y'all ain't with me. So you gotta keep talking to him until he manifests. Look at here. The Bible says he didn't answer her a word, and then his disciples came and besought him. They begged him, saying, send her away, for she cries after us. Now, y'all know I got hot when I read that. Some of your enemies sitting right up in here. Pastor, you said that? Look at your Bible. Look at your Bible now. Them boys walked with Jesus, didn't they? They walked with him. But now, this woman said, Lord, son of David. Now, when I hear that, I'm thinking, oh, man, there's a fellow believer. But yet, they talking about send her away. Wait a minute. This sister just don't praise her way in, and now y'all trying to get rid of her. You know what? Some folk don't want you blessed. They don't. Some people don't want you healed and delivered. Some people don't want to see you prosper because they think you're going to take their place. There's enough in the kingdom for all us, y'all. Look at here. But look, and then they keep talking about she crying after us. Look here. She never did say or call you Lord, nor the son of David. So how you going to get from what she said that she crying after you? You can start tripping on your position and think just because you're walking with God that you are God. Yeah, we're partakers of the divine nature, but he is God. We share in some things with him, but he is Lord. He is King. Don't get it twisted about who's the Savior. Look at here. The Bible says this. But he answered. Now, look here. You don't have to fight against nobody. God take care of that thing for you. Look at this. The Bible said, but he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Here come the test. Even though the word says that he was sent to Israel first, but guess what? What you don't want, somebody else want. What might not look good to you, might look good to somebody else. Yeah, what you reject, somebody else might think, she ain't nothing but a fool. Get rid of you. Man, what was that boy thinking about? Good, you look so good. Y'all ain't with me. Some of y'all don't say that very thing I just said. Evidently, yeah. Pastor tell me, I don't like seeing a man. I said, that's fine. Go find your headed brother then. Remember my wife? Oh, I like skinny brother. Hey, praise the Lord. See, what you don't want, somebody else does. If you don't want Jesus and all that comes with him, there's somebody begging for him. Look at here. Now, here again, he's saying now, I'm sent to Israel. But it's something that faith does. Faith brings you into the family of God. Look at here. The Bible says this. He said, I'm only sent to the lost sheep, those who are perishing in Israel. Then she came and worshiped him. Uh-oh. She said, look here, Jesus, these boys walking with you, they don't know nothing about worship. She came, got on her knees, bowed down. Now I'm going to tell you, if you have grown up in the Black Baptist Church and you've seen folks just laying out and you've seen folks just going, y'all ain't never seen that. Bless your heart. What's wrong with her? She trying to get her blessing. Look, if you need to come lay on this floor, lay out. I ain't going to mess with you. While you're down there, how about give me pray for me too while you're down there? It could be they could be praying for you. Look at here. She said, look here. Them folks in Israel don't know how to worship you. I'm going to show them how to do it. I'm going to bow out. I've told you who you are. Now I'm going to show you who you are. Because you deserve worship and praise and glory. And I'm going to give it to you. Because when I give it to you, you're going to give it to me. Look at here. The Bible says this. She worshiped, and then she pressed in, and she said, Lord, help. Sometimes it don't take a whole hour to pray. Just a few words will do. She said, Lord, look at him. I'm going to break this thing down. I'm not going to try to use no big word, help me. See, sometimes all you got to say, look here, Lord, just help me. I ain't going to even quote no scripture. Look, just help me. The word say you're a very present help. In the time of need, look at here, the Bible says this. But he answered here again. Have you just been, seem like God just keep pushing you back and you pressing in? And folks telling you, God, you just need to get this scripture, that scripture. And it seemed like God ain't showing up. And it seemed like the more you pray and the more you quote scripture, it seemed like the far away God is. Boy, that's when you about to hit your greatest breakthrough. Because you know what he's doing? See, you know what I found? Now, every now and then I get to that point where I want to lift me a few weights. Y'all ain't with me because, you know, every now and then I take my wife to the movies. I want her, you know, sit on them old guns. You know, I want her, you know, grab, ooh, baby, what you been doing? Come down in the weight room, baby. Bless y'all heart. Y'all so holy. But you know what? Getting to the point where I'm buffed up, I lift, and then when that get easy, I have to put on more 45. And the more 45s I put in, the harder it is to push the weight up, but it makes me stronger. See, what God is doing to us when he don't show up right away, he's making you push and press in so that you become spiritually stronger than you were before. And the little stuff that used to bother you last year, that don't even worry you no more. There'll be folks crying over there, and you'll be like, that ain't nothing. I don't been through that. All it is that you've been spiritually lifting your troubles, and God didn't answer right away, and you had to keep pressing in. And now you're strong enough to now spot and help somebody else. Look at here. The Bible says this. He said, now, it ain't meat. It ain't good for me to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs. Uh-oh. Look at here. Now, you can get offended at God.
Amen.
Y'all ain't with me. Go through enough stuff. You'll be want to pull back. Yeah, you will. You can get to the point where you go through so much stuff, you go, you know what? I ain't even going to church. I ain't singing in the choir. I ain't gonna usher. I ain't gonna pray. I ain't gonna do nothing. I ain't gonna read my Bible. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna put it in the attic. I ain't forgiving nobody. Y'all ain't never been there. Bless your heart. You get to the point where you, I don't wanna be bothered with none of them. You get to talking crazy. That ain't no good no way. Am I right about it? Have you ever been there? And then it take the Holy Ghost to get your mind right. And they go, you tripping right now. Now, I ain't let you go yet. I know you're mad at me because I ain't show up when you wanted me to show up. But look at here. Now Jesus said, now, it ain't meat for me to take the children. Now, bread in the Bible can represent this. Jesus said he is the bread that has came down from heaven. Now, he said, now, The Father first gave me to Israel, and he didn't give it to the dogs. Now, this ain't a dog in the way you think about a dog. Now, there's some folk who have dogs who don't come in the house. They stay in the yard, in the fence. But then there are those who have lap dogs. And lap dogs get treated just as good as your children get treated. Y'all ain't with me. The lap dog eat chicken when you eat chicken. They get a slice of cornbread when you get a slice. And if they really spoil, they get a slice of red velvet when you get a slice of red velvet. At least I know one dog who do. Pop Bracey dog eat good. I might want to move in and get me a little water thing sit over there. Good God Almighty. Look at here. Jesus said this to see where she going to be offended. Sometimes God will allow things to move to see if you're going to be offended or either you're going to hold on to your faith. And he said, now look at this. He called her a dog, but he called her a lap dog. Now, since she didn't get offended, Jesus said, I can't just give this thing to you without you first expressing some faith. Y'all ain't with me? See, guess what? Now, your praise and your worship is awesome. But until you exhibit some faith, you ain't going to get what God had for you. Now, look here. See, praise and worship brings him near. It makes him get ready to release it. But faith puts you in the place where he releases it and you can receive it. Look at here. And she said, truth, Lord. Uh-oh. She messed around and agreed with him. She said, Lord, you ain't lying. I know I'm a lap dog. And you know what lap dogs do? Them folks, now where I came from, you didn't waste no crumbs. Grandma taught me how to get the white bread, take it on the plate, and sop everything up. Y'all don't know nothing about that? She said, baby, don't waste nothing now. She said, baby, you take it and you do it just so much so that you wouldn't even have to wash the dish. Marcel and Macy, they looking at me like I'm crazy. And you sop it up with a plate that looks sparkling. She said, baby, you got to be grateful for every single crumb God gives you. The lesson that grandma was trying to teach me said, everything that God gives you, appreciate it. Bless him for it. Lift him up and thank him for it. It's not about you being greedy, but it's you showing appreciation. Don't you know there are folk who would love to just have a slice of bread? There are folk who would love to have a car. Folks would love to have somewhere to live. Would love to have someone that they can be in the family with. And yet you don't appreciate it? Good God Almighty. She said, when the crumbs fall from the master's table, guess what? I'm waiting on. She said, Jesus, them folks wasting you. Jesus, they wasting you. They arguing with you. Coming against you. Making it hard for you to do the work of the Father. But look here, I want you. Even if I could just get a little bit of you. A little bit of you is greater than anything that man can give me. And she said, then Jesus answered, he said, oh, woman. See, guess what? See, when you start exhibiting faith, Jesus get happy. See, guess what? Jesus got so excited that he started like old Baptist preacher. Oh, woman. Greater is my faith. I wish I'm a little animated. Y'all bless my soul. Mama Barbara just shaking her head. But look at here. He said, great is thy faith. When you read your Bible, you're going to find out that the people that Jesus said, great is thy faith, were Gentiles. Amen. They were not Israelites. They were Gentiles. And he said here, he said, be it even unto thee as I. He said, I'm going to give it to you how you want it. Good God Almighty, I've been running around this church. He said, I'm going to give it to you just how you want it. If you show me that faith, I'm going to give it to you. Just like you say you want it, you can have it. If you press your way in through what you're going through, everything that you've been praying for according to his will, I'm going to give it to you just the way you've been asking for it. But what I want to know is, are you going to be offended when I don't show up when you want me to show up? When I tell you you can't get it right now, are you still going to press in? Are you going to keep going till I just say, oh, woman, oh, man, great is thy faith. Look at here. And he said this in front of his disciples. Imagine how they were looking. God want to have the people that tried to reject you to have the skunk face. Y'all ain't never heard about that skunk face. You know the skunk face, do. And the Bible says from that very hour, God did it. Not next week, but he said that very hour. You know, faith start making things work right away. That very hour. Guess what? She with Jesus, talking to Jesus. Once Jesus said, you know what? You're going to get it as you will. Those words went right back to Tara and Sidon, to her house. The word can go to your house while you up here. If your faith is operating when you get home, that thing is already changed up. But God just wants you to operate by faith. Quick recap. He's headed to you because some folks don't want him. Talk to him. Tell him who he is. Whatever your case is, whatever you need, there are so many names for God, we don't even use most of them. But guess what? He's your peace. He's your joy. He's your salvation. He's your deliverance. He's your healer. He's your way maker. As a matter of fact, Paul put it this way in the book of Corinthians. He's my all and all in all. Whatever your case is, he can work it all out for you. He is your all and all. But the older I get, and I pray he keep blessing me with years, I'm finding out, but no matter what it is, no matter what the case, but guess what? He is undefeated. Good God Almighty, never lost a case. Guess what? Second of all, after you tell him who he is, state your case. When you get disappointed, when he don't answer right away, just start worshiping. And then once you start worshiping, you get on your face, because the Bible says this. When you humble yourself before the Lord, the Bible says he will exalt you in due time. He's going, as a matter of fact, he lifts up bald heads, the book of Psalms. Not only that, don't get offended when he talks to you. When he tells you to forgive somebody. Y'all ain't with me. See, sometimes we want stuff and then God show us an area that we need to do something. He'll show it to you. He did me like that. Not too long ago, just last week. He did. I was begging and asking for something. And he said, you really want it? I said, yeah, Lord. He said, pray for him. I said, oh. He said, you want it? I said, yeah. Pray for him. I said, okay, Lord. And he said, you're being slow. God don't talk to y'all like that. I said, okay, Lord. But once I started praying, God said, you are helping him, and he don't even know. He said, he is the key to your blessings being released because it was being held up. I'm just sharing that testimony with somebody who's wondering why it ain't been released. Well, he can't release it until you release. And then he said, you can have it just how you want it. Because you know what I had been praying for? You remember when I told you that God was going to send money down this way? And I was like, Lord, I ain't got no checks from nobody in a few, you know, it's been about a week now. And then he said, well, do what I asked you to do. And then right after that, I started getting the phone calls. See, y'all ain't with me. You know what? It could be, we can be helped in that if we let some folks go in forgiveness. See, we don't know how what we do and how we react is tied up to not only our personal lives, but our corporate lives. Look at here. Watch God do it, even though it may have taken a long time. Watch him do it in that hour. The doors to the kingdom of God are open.